Hello. I've got a fun idea for you today. I'm going to try to answer this question as quickly as possible. Now, someone was asking if they could make a tunnel with straight lines in it from Trapcode Tao, and this is what they'd gotten so far, which was not what they wanted. This is the reference of something they were more interested in. So, let's see how fast we can make this using Trapcode Tao. We are here in After Effects with a completely blank project file, and we can start the timer. New composition, that looks pretty good. And we'll start off by making the texture for our tunnel. We'll want VR fractal noise for this one because it gives us a nice seamless texture. And I'm going to leave that pretty much at its default. I'm going to use universe multitone on this in tritone format. You can use tritone, but I like some of the controls you get with multitone. I'm going to give it kind of a nice, cyan color there. Midtones are going to be black. And the highlights are going to be kind of a pinky color there. Or the shadows, I mean. We don't need any contrast, and the midpoint can be 0.5. Just kind of give us that kind of a nice look there. So that's going to be the main texture for our DAO. Speaking of DAO, let's add our DAO in here. And we'll turn off the fractal. You know what? Let's name these layers Fractal. And we'll name this one DAO. And we will add DAO to it. We do not want this path generator to be making anything. We're going to want to drive this from a mask. I'll just drop a quick mask on here, like so. Now, if you're wondering how I got the mask to be so curvy when I'm just clicking, I had the roto bezier ticked on. And that just gives you automatic curves. Anyway, we will take this mask path here, copy it, because I'm going to put it into the camera position. 24 millimeter, yeah, that should be good. So camera position, paste. That jumps it to the spot in 3D space, and then I'll just rotate it on X, is it? Maybe Y? There we go, we're looking down the tunnel. That's good enough for now. We will animate the camera later. So for the segments, we don't need the caps at all, and we don't wanna break the sides or chamfer it, and we probably want about, 16 sides or so, because what we're doing is we're extruding this N-gon down the length of our path here, and we probably just want some more segments in our tunnel. I actually want this to be a pretty smooth tunnel without having to crank up the number of sides here. So under our shader, instead of being flat, we'll just change that to smooth and make it nice and smooth. Although I think these edges here are still a little harsh, so maybe we'll put 32 sides in there. It's much better. And then for our textures, we want that fractal noise. So we'll go and say for our color texture, we'll use the fractal layer with its effects and masks. Still looks kind of like that cloudy stuff. We'll make the scale on the Y maybe 6 and 0.2 on the X. Should give us, say, here we go. Got some stripy lines. We kind of want those to glow. So we'll add some optical glow on there. Boost the amount up, the size up. Boost them out even more. And you know what? We'll make highlights only come up some so it only glows off certain parts of the tunnel. And of course, some renoiser as well. Always want to use that on top of anything with glows and gradients. And there you go. Just got to animate the camera's rotation so it looks, down the tunnel where you need to go. Here, make that 90. And then just animate your camera on the Y and perhaps add something on the outside of your tunnel.